Sri Ramakrishna and M were now conversing alone. M. Sir, if it is God Himself who has become everything, then why do people have so many different feelings? Master, undoubtedly God exists in all beings as the all-pervading spirit. But the manifestations of His power are different in different beings. In some places, there is a manifestation of the power of knowledge. In others, of the power of ignorance. In some places, there is a greater manifestation of power than in others. Don't you see that among human beings, there are cheats and gamblers? To say nothing of men who are like tigers. I think of them as the cheat god, the tiger god. M. With a smile. We should salute them from a distance. If we go near the tiger god and embrace him, he may devour us. Master. He and his power. Brahman and its power. Nothing else exists but this. In a hymn to Rama, Narada said, O Ram, you are Shiva and Sita is Bhagavati. You are Brahma and Sita is Brahmani. You are Indra and Sita is Indrani. You are Narayan and Sita is Lakshmi. O Ram, you are the symbol of all that is masculine and Sita of all that is feminine. M. Sir, what is the spirit form of God like? Sri Ramakrishna reflected a moment and said softly, Shall I tell you what it is like? It is like water. One understands all this through spiritual discipline. Believe in the form of God. It is only after attaining Brahma Jnana that one sees non-duality, the oneness of Brahman and its Shakti. Brahman and Shakti are identical, like fire and its power to burn. When a man thinks of fire, he must also think of its power to burn. Again, when he thinks of the power to burn, he must also think of fire. Further, Brahman and Shakti are like milk and its whiteness, water and its wetness. But there is a stage beyond even Brahma Jnana. After Jnana comes Vijnana. He who is aware of knowledge is also aware of ignorance. The sage Vasishtha was stricken with grief at the death of his 100 sons. Asked by Lakshmana, why a man of knowledge should grieve for such a reason? Ram said, Brother, go beyond both knowledge and ignorance. He who has knowledge has ignorance also. If a thorn has entered your foot, get another thorn, and with its help, take out the first. Then throw away the second also. M. Should one throw away both knowledge and ignorance? Master. Yes. That is why one should acquire vijnana. You see, he who is aware of light is also aware of darkness. He who is aware of happiness is also aware of suffering. He who is aware of virtue is also aware of vice. He who is aware of good is also aware of evil. He who is aware of holiness is also aware of unholiness. He who is aware of I is also aware of you. What is vijnana? It is knowing God in a special way. The awareness and conviction that fire exists in wood is jnana, knowledge. But to cook rice on that fire, eat the rice and get nourishment from it is vijnana. To know by one's inner experience that God exists is jnana. But to talk to him, to enjoy him as a child, as a friend, as master, as beloved, is vijnana. The realization that God alone has become the universe and all living beings is vijnana. According to one school of thought, God cannot be seen. Who sees whom? Is God outside you that you can see him? One sees only oneself. Having once entered the black waters of the ocean, the ship does not come back, and so cannot describe what it experiences. M. It is true, sir. As you say, having climbed to the top of the monument, one becomes unaware of what is below. Horses and carriages, men and women, houses, shops and offices, and so on. Master, I don't go to the Kali temple nowadays. Is that an offense? At one time, Narendra used to say, "What? He still goes to the Kali temple?" M. Every day, you are in a new state of mind. How can you ever offend God? Master, someone said to Sen about Hriday, "He is very ill. Please bring 2 pieces of cloth and a couple of shirts for him. We will send them to his village." Sen offered only 2 rupees. "How do you explain that? He has so much money, and yet he is so miserly." "What do you say to that?" M. Those who seek God cannot behave that way. I mean, those whose goal is the attainment of knowledge. Master, God alone is the reality, and all else is unreal.